On this next adventure, me, the self-sufficient cyclist, will be headed to seaside resort Skegness with my two good friends, Mikey and Steve. Then the three of us will be biking back home over 80 miles. On our return, we'll be wild camping and looking for a wild meal, even if that does mean fishing out our supper. Well, it's the first day of our Nottingham to Skegness back to Nottingham biking adventure, and it's been raining all morning, so it wasn't a surprise when Mikey and Steve arrived and they were already dripping wet. But this wasn't going to dampen our spirits, as the weather was forecast to change for the better later on and for the following few days. So we've arrived at the station early so we can have something quickly to eat before boarding the train. We just hope we're not contending for bike space between the two carriages. The one-way train tickets cost us £22, but this still didn't guarantee we'll be getting all three bikes on the train. So we feared for the worst. But today, there were no other cyclists commuting, which meant more space for our bikes and the rest of our equipment.
On the train, bro.
All good. Phase two of the operation.
Yeah, done. Got the bikes out.
The train journey is around 2 hours, and we would arrive in Skegness a couple of hours before the sea was at high tide. And as I was planning on trying some landlining from the shore for fish, it made good sense to rig up some hooks. After we had finished making our hook lengths, we played a bit of money football to pass even more time.
Yes.
5-3.
To me.
As soon as we arrived in Skeg, we headed straight down to the sea to try setting the landlines using long lengths of hazel pushed into the sand. The idea was to keep the baited hooks a foot from the seabed and out of reach of crabs. But the waves were too powerful and tore away our chances. It was a great feeling to be by the coast, and this brought back memories of when I was a young child on summer holidays. Only this time I could forget about work.
So we failed at fishing, landlining. Hopefully try again, but nah. Let's nip to the Tesco and get ourselves some easy food. Yeah. I find a camp somewhere to come. Let me find somewhere to come.
With supplies for the night, it was important we find somewhere to set camp and not too far away from the beach so we could reset our lines at low tide. And this was going to be around 3 a.m. During these early hours, dog walkers should be fast asleep in bed and away from our hooks. With the tent set, it was time to enjoy the rest of the night before heading back down to the beach to reset the lines again. It was going to be a long night ahead of us, so Mike's rave music was much needed to keep us awake. After resetting our lines, we finally got a few hours sleep with my alarm set for 9 a.m. It felt like we had barely closed our eyes before we were awake again, and what I thought was the ideal place to camp wasn't so perfect, as the land around us was starting to fill up with seawater. And as it was heading our way, it soon became a race against the tide to pack away our things before this trip was a total washout. I was now pleased I brought my wellies along. Even if it did add a bit more weight to my luggage, I just can't stand having wet feet. Steve, on the other hand, wasn't so lucky and got his only pair of footwear drenched through. Reassembled, we headed down to the beach to check our lines, if our attempts hadn't been beached again. Steve wouldn't stop talking about breakfast, but I insisted we wait. But was we waiting in vain? Then through the waves I could see my hazel sticks popping out. I pushed and screwed those sticks as deep as I could, and they stood up against the waves. Unfortunately for us, we didn't catch any fish, so we removed our hooks and our line so we wasn't endangering any untargeted species, like a greedy gull or a beach walker's dog.
Getting ready for a nice long bike ride down some long country roads.
Dangerous country roads.
Dangerous country roads. How are you feeling about that, Mikey?
Whatever happens, happens. Obviously, I'm going out my way to get noticed.
Yeah, man.
It was soon time to begin our biking trip, and that meant going along some dangerous roads. The idea was to cover as many miles so it wasn't rushing in our final days. The weather had improved after all, but the news did warn 70 miles per hour winds. The first 12 miles was a comfortable ride. We stopped for refreshments and fishing supplies in the village of Spilsby, and then we cycled onwards until we managed to reach the Witham River. And after our failed saltwater fishing earlier on in the day, our thoughts turned to freshwater fish.
I'm gonna fish this then. Try fishing.
I was hoping we'd catch something of a sustainable size, but something big enough we could share. I'd already heard pike and perch were good eating, and I would try fishing for these with a range of lures and plugs. Steve decided to fish with a float, a shallow 3 foot, closer to the bank. His float was then pulled down under the water, and Steve raised the first fish of the trip. It wasn't his personal best, but then he added more to his tally, and a fish supper looked promising.
Hello, Steve.
I kept on trying with the lures, but I wasn't having any luck. It was down to Steve, who hooked a couple of perch to add to the fish feast.
That's the best side. Second perch of the day. This trip's turning out to be quite a
Fishful.
Fishful.
So I finished fishing, never managed to catch that pike I was after, using the lures. But thankfully Steve was still on form and has managed to catch a few smaller fish. And we're going to take those with us and just fry them up with some garlic and stuff. And the biggest we've got, or what Steve got, is that perch. Not a huge size, but it'll be nice to see what it tastes like.
We found a wood just off the road and it was time to cook our catch. We stewed half a dozen of fresh and gutted dace with vegetables and chili powder and fried a pair of perch in a marinade of garlic and lemon. That was after we descaled them.
The whole reason I bought it, mate, is to make the
stew. That's it.
An hour later and the stew was ready. Each small mouthful was spoiled with fragments of sharp tiny bones, which I hoped would have softened. The vegetables were perfect and the stock of the stew was delicious, much to the delight of Micah, who sipped away his bony broth.
A lot of chilli in it. But,
getting bones.
It was too many bones in it. But nice.
Just as it was getting dark, we got to speak to a farmer who was about to finish for the night. He kindly let us pitch our tent in his field.
Got the bacon on now. To go with the sausages.
Yeah.
So bacon and sausage sarnies. Raw jamming with an alcoholic beverage.
And a roll up extra large.
Yep. To go around.
We fried up the last of our Lincolnshire sausages and snacked on apples that Mikey picked from the roadside earlier on in the day.
Nice, dude. Lincolnshire sausage.
We had no idea what type of apples these ones were. Even though they looked edible, they were possibly covered in poisonous emissions from busy traffic. So we gave them a good wipe over before eating.
I think I'll go for the pair of them. No, I'll go for this one instead.
It's the second morning of a tour. We all got a better sleep last night. We had about 6 hours. The water's done, by the way. I get these pot noodles.
It's gonna be hot enough, mate. Go outside, Bruce.
Today we're going to carry on to Sleaford. The wind has picked up and this is going to make cycling difficult. It's Lincolnshire after all, and the flat land don't offer as much protection from the high winds.
Winds against us.
So we've just come out of Sleaford, followed the river,
and now we're on this road.
We don't know where to go. Left.
All right.
What way should we go? What way? Left. Right.
So after guessing which way to go, we soon realised we're heading towards Grantham. Even though slightly concerned about the fast roads ahead of us, I was double worried about my back wheel. I was obviously carrying too much weight, and this had caused my wheel axle to snap. Maybe I should have left my muck boots at home.
They're in my bag. Can I tell the camera what we're doing?
Put the tent up. Just made a coffee. Now I'm going to put my sunglasses on.
Pretty bright, isn't it?
Pretty bright.
Say it's about 6 o'clock, somewhere around.
Yeah, about 6 o'clock, half 6.
So we've managed to reach the outskirts of Grantham and we've chosen this field to pitch up the tent in the final moments of sunset. We've really got a cracking view. And no, I don't mean Steve's bare cheeks.
Thanks, Stephen. That's much better.
Then for the last time, we pack away our equipment into our bags and onto our bikes as we prepare to go through Grantham along the A52 back into Nottinghamshire.
Come on, Bob. Watch where you're going, bro. Only 16 miles left. Let's fucking keep going.
It's been a fantastic 3-day trip with the guys, and if anything, a taste of what's to come with future adventures. And we do hope to improve on our bushcraft, our hunting and foraging, as we challenge ourselves to become more self-sufficient as we bike around Britain.
Catch some fish. Yeah, check it out. YouTube, country, product, country wise.